So we will go ahead with our pattern of discussion. So today market really made a move which is really gave a lot of opportunity for the traders in the sense those who are having the clear levels were following what we are all discussing. We are all discussing really, you know, every week the important key levels of the markets. Of course, you are following and making use of it. Every day, market really, you know, makes like 50 points to 70 points minimum in the case of Nifty. That is also giving wider opportunity for the people to make an entry. Okay, so what happened today? You will see the market from the beginning. When you see the big fall in the afternoon was really recovered by the help of Infosys. So Infosys, the main contributor for the Nifty index or the overall index, they got up this Q2 earning. So generally, when you talk about the earning, the first sector which is likely to provide the results are IT sectors. So there is a big expectation of IT sector. When all other sectors were in difficult situation, the eye is kept on only the IT sector, which is expected to produce a better result than any other sectors in our Indian market segments. So today, even though in the morning, TCS was very badly hit and it required now the help of Infosys, and let us see how Infosys can help. So totally, if you look into overall situation, so the important all 11 sectors are today ended in a green. So they are all ended higher today, which is complementing the market with the back end. Particularly, the index metal, it made a big gain today. It really pushed the market at the higher side. Of course, the other way around, the media sector was the most affected. But even though it has fallen, the range is much, much lesser than the gains when you look into. You watch today's market, when you are watching today's indices, you can see here. So this is how market opened. Actually, this is the small gap. After opening a gap, you start marching. It marched nearly, if you see, there's a big seesaw. Go up, no, 100 points, close to 100 points, and it was resisted here. After resisting here, it just crashed in a sense, even went below to the yesterday's, I mean, last week's close, and it is it was in red at around 11 o'clock. From that, slowly you can see it is making a higher bottom and went up, and then last also close to the same level, but still the trend of the day after 11 o'clock is still intact. So as long as this trend is intact, market likely to move further up, and this 11,350 may act as the resistance. So this is the, you know, general scenario when I'm looking into the day chart. Of course, any fall below these 250 levels. Now the range is like this, 11,350 and 250. So this range is giving you an opportunity for trading. Of course, the directional trend may emerge. Now we are on to the advances and decline for the day. And you see the advances decline. This I'm giving you compared with the last week to this week. And last Friday when we met, there was a big, you know, fall in the market. Like, you know, 38 stocks were in the red out of 50 and 12 were in green. So this was giving us a very, very difficult situation to make all to understand the further fall can be imminent. That is the situation you see, majority of the stocks were in red. So advances were even like, no, less than 20%. Contrary to that, today when you are watching move, this is the advances are 38, almost like, no, like the opposite of what we faced last week, 38 and 38. 35 ounces. The declines are also comparatively, yes, it is just opposite situation of last Friday to this Friday, and but still still we are not in a position to say the market recovered it fully. It is going to be a script based movements, and market may on the sideway overall because of the recent season. Last week, this is the scenario. Last week, I told you, the majority of the sectors were in red, but only two were in green. But this week, if you look into the majority sectors are green, only few of the sectors are in red. So today, as I told you in the beginning, the metal sector was the king. Now it moved 2.35%, and really, it gave a big push to the market. Then followed by Nifty IT, 1.51% IT stocks, IT sector went up, and realty is 0.96. Of course, we look into some of the important sectors like FMCG also, it is on the move with 0.84%. And the other important sectors we look into, banking sector also moved up with 0.7% today. So overall, when you look into the important sectors, gave a good amount of support the market. But on the other side, the public sector enterprises and media sectors were the worst affected comparatively this week today. So today, the world indices. So when you look into the world indices, all are in green. That is a big situation where the US market, Dow Jones was up by 0.5%, S&P 500 also up by 0.6, Nasdaq also with 0.6%. When the American market closed in green, that gave a good amount of strength for the Asian markets to open up in green. And Asian markets like Shanghai, Hang Seng, Nikkei, all the major indices were up from 0.8% to 2.34%. So overall, when I looked into the Asian markets also having a lot of strength, that strength was transformed to the Indian market to open in green and moved up very strongly. Of course, after the fall we found in the Indian market, the mid-session was supported by the European markets. The European markets, when you are looking into, really you can see all three, the important indices like DAX, CAC, FTSE, all of them were up by 1.36%. So the German indices was moving up with 1.96, the highest among the three. Next, the France index and CAC was moved by 1.26%, and FTSE is 0.36%. Of course, the Brexit issue still on the cards. The draft of UK was not accepted by European Union. All the struggle is still going on. Still, the overall market scenario ended in green, that is a positive thing. This is the FIA activities. When you are watching this FIA situation here, you can see the FIAs were really turning the cards, and overall, if you look into till today, this month, till today, they were all net sellers to the tune of 4,034 crores. So contrary to that, the DAs were biased to the tune of 5,336 crores. This is the net push. But when you look into day by day, on daily basis, from 3rd October till 10th of October, you can see the FIs are only sellers, sellers, sellers. Every day they were only selling in the Indian market, and our DAs were compensating their sales, and they are able to maintain the market at the current level. So the market is holding on this level mainly because of the FIs, mainly because of the DAs. Continuous buying support in the Indian market. Of course, we need to study the open interest. I was educating you how to read the open interest. also I was explaining you on every week how to compare the closing price, the opening interest, in order to understand the market movement. Now let us also look into this. The last 2 weeks when we looked into the price of the Nifty from 11,579, you can see here, now from here to here, it started drifting lower. So when they were moving lower this area, you can see the opening interest started going up. 1.45 crores, 1.46, 1.54, 1.58, 1.54, after that small correction here. So you can see there's some kind of short covering also could have taken place. Once again, it picked up. So now all this area, when you look into the open interest is going up, the price is falling. But the situation started changing afterwards. You can see after reaching 1.5, slowly the open interest slowly started increasing, and you can see the price also started from here onwards. You can see all the short covering, you can say here, these are all short covering. So short covering made the price, short covering helped the price to go up, the contracts started coming down, number of contracts started coming down from 1.5 to 1.45. So this is how the open interest is giving us a lot of information, right? So open interest study. Thank you everybody. So open interest study helps you to understand who is strong. Who is strong, that is bull or bear. Also it is helping you to understand what action is taking place in the market. So this is also telling us what action is taking place in the market. So this is how we should study the open interest. Of course, this is the open interest till 10th of October. But today's open interest also we should look into or consider for further. From 1.5, 1 point, so 1 crore 45 lakhs, no? That is the present situation. And let us see how today changed from 1.45, how much it change today. We'll see. This is today's open interest. I'll just show you how much it has changed today. The open interest change is 8.25 lakhs. That means from 1.5 it has changed to 1.53. So 1.53 is giving us the information that today the open interest OI increased and price also increased. Okay. So this is giving an indication that market is showing some amount of strength. So currently you can say OA indicates there is a fresh buying taking. I indicate there is a fresh buying techniques. Okay, so this is how we study the open interest. The study of open interest will definitely help every market participant to take appropriate decision in this market.